I will make a few videos, or maybe a video or two or three, how many videos I will do on this kit. I don't know in how many videos I will be covering it, its maintenance. So I am going to make maintenance on this one. The problem with this car is, as this you can see, this is a carbureted car. This is not a fuel injected. There is no throttle body. But the problem with this car is it is not idling. It is not staying start. Instead, it is going shutting down and stalling while we are not on the pedal, accelerator pedal. So this is the problem, and also there is a poor starting condition for this car. These CNG cars or gas cars, whatever, this natural gas car, they need, the kit needs a maintenance after a certain interval. So a long time this had not been maintained. I will show maintenance on this one, as this video is very, very much important, because maximum people here, they have such arrangement of the cars, in their cars such arrangement is there. They are running on gas, so I will make maintenance on this one and will shoot video, so that anybody who have some basic tools like this, very few basic tools and skill to perform such a maintenance. So for this one I'm starting, and I'm little bit explaining to you what this kit is doing, so that you will understand fully what is going on. So here you can see first thing is this gas line is coming from the cylinder, and here is the gauge. This is from the rear cylinder, it is coming. So here it is entering to this kit, and high pressure is coming over here, and then there are a few diaphragms, and here is the control. This is the solenoid, actually, which is electrical connections are, and here is another solenoid. You can see this one. This one is the main solenoid, which is controlling the gas, while this solenoid is getting, both are getting power actually the same time. They are parallel. 12 volt is coming from this battery, controlled parallel, control 12 volt is coming. So while this is switched on, the gas is coming into the kit, and it is controlling, the pressure is controlled, and from here this is going to the carburetor intake. So this kit is working on the principle of negative pressure or negative displacement or whatever, the suction. The simplest word which I can use is the suction. So on the suction, this kit is working. So while the engine is making a vacuum over there while it is running, so this kit is supplying enough quantity of gas to run this engine. So the gas quantity from here in this pipe is proportional to the vacuum. So this is what is the basic principle how this works. But the problem with these kits is so after a certain time they accumulate dirt and some debris inside, and whatever, this liquid component of the gas, which is not a gas actually, which is some other content of some other natural content which is coming with the gas, and that's not good for the kit. I mean, it is creating a problem with your drivability of the car. So after a certain time, it is important that we have to clean these kits, and we have to maintain, and whatever part is bad, we will replace. So first of all, we should have to switch off the control valve of this gas, so that the gas should not come over here while we are working on this kit. Here is the CNG cylinder, and here is the valve which we have to close before attempting the maintenance job on this cylinder, this CNG kit. So some way, as it will be written also over here, you will see. Let us see, on this side we will close it or we will shut it. So now it's shut. So for that, after that, we have to remove this nut using a regular open spanner or whatever, this adjustable. I can open this. I already lose it actually. There was a little pressure which had been released. So here you can see, just I'm opening with my hand. While it is already loosened, but still there is some rust is there inside, which I can feel, and that's why it needs a little bit tool to make it open. This is what I'm showing, small details even, so that anybody who is working on his car or on her car will be easily understand what is going on behind, and there will be no problem to attempt such a job. So you can see this had been removed from. Now we will keep it aside, and then now is the time to remove this electrical connections. Electrical is simple enough. This is not very much complex. Here is the positive one we have to remove, and here is another positive which is coming to the kit. We will remove, and then of course it is coming over here also to the gauge. This is the gauge, actually gauge unit. So we will remove it from here. Maybe we will cut it, and then later on we will joint it again. So this will be the way. And also this ground which had been come, we have provided actually two grounds. This also we will have to remove. So this ground I will have to remove it. So by this way it will come off, and this one we should have to cut it down, and later on we will connect it again. So some way like this. Now it had been detached, and only ground is still there. You can see here is the ground, and that's also we have to detach it from here by opening this bolt. We will bring this kit off as well from the car. Grab the nut and remove the bolt from. Things are going rusty, so that's why they are a bit difficult to remove. So now this washer we will keep it, and nut also. And then later on we will put them again while we will be fixing. So by this way, as you can see, underneath also they have put one stud inside, so we will remove that also, which will be from here. And of course one connection, the gas connection, we will remove from here. Using a screwdriver we can open this, and this electrical, of course we will remove the negative post of the battery so that we will not create any short circuit or something like that. Okay, we will keep it aside, and then this one we will gently remove, and we'll keep it in the car. And this stud, this stud part we will be removing from the car using whatever the open spanner or adjustable wrench. Removing that stud from body, just I removed this kit from, and now you can see it is opened, and this will bring this kit off of the car. So now you can see this is in my hand. Now I will have to show you what is going on with this kit. As you can see, this is oily from here, and of course this oil that is from the gas, what I am expected, you will see inside while I will open it. So opening is straightforward. I will remove all the nuts and bolts from this kit. That I will show you step by step, because this job is important. And this was also important, how to remove it from the car. That's why this video will go in parts. So hope you people will understand the situation, and hope this video will also serve its purpose as the people who are working on their gaskets. So this is a regular Lenti Renzo, you can see. This is a Lenti Renzo kit. which is a very common kit from Italy, and they are making it here also. It is written, so you can see. The next part, I will show you how to dismantle this and how to check inside, how to inspect parts, how to clean, and then how to fix it. So keep on watching and stay tuned for the next parts. Like, please, and also subscribe on my channel.